Hey, what's up YouTube? I went ahead and I built another application using Microsoft's Visual Basic 2008 Express Edition. This time I went ahead and I built an application that will change the administrator password using this application here. As a lot of people probably don't know that changing the administrator password for Windows Vista or Windows XP, but mainly for Windows Vista, is done through the command prompt. But my application will do that just using itself, so you don't have to do any work, just click one button. Okay, so as you guys can probably see here, I have my application here. Let me just go ahead and show you the different properties of the application. First of all, the name of the application is called Set Admin Password. And if you come over here, I left it still at Form 1. Okay, so the form border style, my form border style is set to fixed single, as you can see, right there. And come down here a little bit. I don't show my icon, so that's set to false. Show in taskbar is also false. It doesn't use up any room in the taskbar when it loads. Okay, and here's the text for the title right there. Okay, let's go back over here, and I'll show you this over here. Okay, I have a group box. Group box is not really special, it's just there for design. I have a label. What password would you like to use, it says. I have a text box, and the text box has a specific name, and the text box specific name is set to admin path. And I have a button here, and the button's name is called B underscore set admin passcode. B underscore meaning it's a button. Okay. And also if we come down here, you'll see that I have four timers. Now I tried to do this application using one timer and it's just not possible. So I have T01, T02, T03, and T04 as the timers. Okay, and let's go inside of our code. Let's go ahead and double click on the button here. And let's take a look at the code. Okay, I'm inside the code here, and so when we first click our button, B underscore set admin passcode underscore click, I have a variable associated with that, dim start CMD as string equals E Windows system 32 CMD.exe. So it starts the command prompt, pretty much. Now you'll notice that my drive is a little bit different than everybody else's. Normally the command prompt is located at C, Windows, System 32, CMD.exe. But I have two operating systems on my computer, and Windows XP is installed on the E drive, and Microsoft Windows Vista is installed on the C drive. Okay, so that's why I have mine set as E. So process.start, start CMD. Okay, let's come down here. Okay, so T01 that enabled equals true, and it starts the first timer labeled T01. Each timer is the interval is set to 1 second. I slowed it down for you guys so you guys can see the application working. Okay, I can set it as fast as 500 milliseconds, which is equivalent to half a second. Okay, so if you double click on the first timer labeled T01, it comes in here, and then you can edit the events and code and stuff for the first timer. Sendkeys.send CD change directory, and it changes it to here, to Windows System 32. And then it presses enter. Okay. After it does that, it enables the next timer, T02, got enabled equals true. Okay. Under the second timer, labeled T02, it disables the timer previous, the previous timer, sends keys dot send, CLS, enter, clear screen, and then after that, it enables the next timer. Next timer, T03, disables the previous timer, send keys dot send, net users, net users administrator, little Aristarchus symbol right there, and it presses enter. After it does that, it enables the next timer. And the next timer says, disable the previous timer. I have a variable here, and the variable says dim admin passcode as string equals admin pass.txt, which is the text box on the form. Okay? And after that, it says send keys that send, add whatever passcode that you enter into the text box that you want to set the administrator passcode to. It enters the passcode, presses enter, send keys that send, admin passcode, and presses enter again to confirm. And then the last timer kills itself. Okay? And that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead and let's run this application so I can show you guys what's going on here. Okay? And as you can see here, here's our little application. I'm going to go ahead and make the screen a little bit bigger so you guys can see. That should be big enough right there. So let me go ahead and so you enter your passcode into here and you press the button. So let's go ahead and run the application. And as you can see, it completed successfully. So that is my video tutorial on how to make an application that changes the administrator password to whatever password that you want. Thanks a lot for watching my video tutorial. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on more interesting subjects. Thanks a lot. Goodbye.